Hello students, welcome back for the part 6th session. The new chapter name is Joint Venture in the subject of Advanced Financial Accounting for BCom second sem students. Let us start with some introduction of this new chapter. Always I used to say a business opportunities will be there many. Each one gives a place for starting a new entity. In the process of structuring the form of that particular activity, sole trading takes first place, where a single owner bears all the risk and returns of concern apart from the sharing work with his workers. All small and medium enterprises come under this category of ownership. Secondly, partnership firm, which includes group of people who are ready to share the work as well as risk and also return in their concerns what they are doing as business. All medium and semi-medium of industries are under this category of ownership. And thirdly, company established under Indian Companies Act 1956. Here they subscribes capital from the public by selling their shares. It limits the liability of the shareholders to the nominal value of their share investments. If I talk about the modern business environment, has created many other sub-forms of entities. One among them is joint venture. Though it is similar to the form of partnership, it works on the short-term objectives. These are the units established to meet short-term need. Once that objective is completed, then the entity or that joint venture will come to an end. Generally, joint venture is entitled to support the large-scale projects and programs. When two or more persons are started to do a joint venture, then how they need to maintain the books of accounts is the next question mark. So in this chapter, we are going to learn how the joint venture is going to maintain books of accounts in case of journal entries and also in case of ledger entries under different methods. Now let us start with the meaning. Joint venture, it is a temporary form of business where two or more persons join together to meet the short-term objectives. It is quite similar to partnership firm but established without name or registration separately under any law. Example, construction of building. Under this, two or more persons will join together and they will start a new business in the name of joint venture. And here, those persons will make this business for short-term objective. And whenever the profit or loss they used to get from this, they will share based on the agreement what they have made. And if they are not making any agreement to share the profit and losses, it will be distributed equally. And these kind of businesses will start without keeping a name of the business and also without registration. It is not there separately for this joint ventures. A best example I can give that a construction of building. So in order to construct and in order to sell those buildings, so many people will join together and they will start a new venture by not keeping any name and by sharing their profits and losses equally or with an agreement. The two or more people who start joint venture to achieve the short-term objectives and ready to share the risk and return in the venture are called co-ventures. They are similar to partnership. In the partnership form, so whoever is going to start a venture with the two or more persons, those persons will be called as co-ventures. They are ready to take the risk as well as returns in the venture, and also they share the profits and losses based on the agreement or based on the equal portion. And this venture objective will be short term. Once it is completed, they will close the venture. And it is almost similar to partnership firm, how the partners used to be there in the partnership firm. In the same manner, the persons or ventures, co-ventures will be there in the joint venture. But in partnership firm, they used to follow the act. But here, there will be no separate act in order to follow under joint venture. Now, let us see some difference between joint venture and partnership firm. The first one says name of the venture. In case of joint venture, it does not have any name of running business. In case of partnership firm, it has its own name of running business. Usually, when anybody started with a business, they used to keep a business name. But in case of joint venture, it is not required at all. But in case of partnership firm, they usually start with the name of the firm. And the second point is nature of member, that is members in joint venture are co-ventures, members in partnership firm are partners. In both the cases, there will be a persons in order to do the business. In case of joint venture, they will be called as co-ventures. In case of partnership firm, they will be called as partners. Nature of objective, temporary or short-term objective are set in joint venture. Long-term objective are set in partnership firm. So when I talk about the objective of the business or entity, in case of joint venture, it will be very short. Once that objective is completed, the business will come to an end. But in case of partnership firm, the objective may require with a long term. Fourth is a registration of firm. No registration of the business under any law. Registration is optional but available. So in case of registration, under joint venture, it is not required of doing a registration. But in case of partnership firm, it may be optional, but almost all the firms used to register under Partnership Act 1972. Then we have books of accounts. No separate set of books are maintained in the books of joint venture. Separate set of books are maintained in the books of partnership firm. In case of joint venture, maintaining of books of accounts, it is optional. They can maintain books of accounts in a separate way, or they can maintain in books of accounts under any co-venture. But in case of partnership firm, it is required to maintain separate set of books of accounts under partnership firm. Next, we have freedom for additional business. Co-ventures have freedom to do similar business and compete. Partners do not freedom to do similar business and compete. In case of joint venture, the same activity or same business can be done by the co-venture. They can do the similar kind of business in any places without asking any permission. They will have some freedom to do that. But in case of a partnership firm, they don't have any freedom to do the same kind of business in any other places. Then we have dissolution. Joint venture is dissolved as soon as its work has been completed. Partnership is dissolved only at the mutual opinion of partners. So when the joint venture need to close, the joint venture will be closed when the objective of that venture is completed. Once the activity or business came with an objective end, then they can close the joint venture. In case of partnership firm, with the opinion of the partners, they can close the partnership firm also. And one more point we can say, that is admission of a minor. In case of a joint venture, a minor cannot be admitted in a joint venture as he is incompetent to contract. In case of partnership firm, a minor can be admitted to the benefit of the firm. In case of joint venture, the accounting concept that you'll use regarding with the liquidation basis. In case of partnership firm, they use the accounting concept as a going concern concept. The methods of maintaining joint venture accounts. There are different methods adopted for recording joint venture transactions. They can be broadly classified into the following two methods. One method is when separate set of books are maintained. Second one is when separate set of books are not maintained. So as you can see, I have marked it. Separate set of books are maintained. When they are maintaining separate set of books of accounts, then they need to prepare three ledger accounts. One is a joint bank account, then one is joint venture account, one is personal account of co-ventures. So these three will be prepared. And in case of a separate set of books of accounts are not maintained, under that two category will come. One is when each co-venture keep record of own transactions only. When the co-venture record their own transactions, so for that also they are going to prepare the ledger account in the name of a memorandum joint venture account and joint venture with co-venture account. In case of other category, when each co-venture keep record of all transactions. So here each co-venture will keep all the transactions which will be related to other co-ventures also. One is joint venture account and co-ventures account. So these two ledger account will be prepared. So along with that, instead of preparing ledger account, they can prepare the journal entries also. In the examination part, so whatever the separate set of books are maintained, they have given, those three ledger account we are supposed to prepare for 14 marks. They will ask that for 14 marks, whatever the other thing we have, that is no separate set of books are maintained. So under that we have two categories. Any one of these category can be asked for 6 marks. They may ask you to prepare journal entries or they may ask you to prepare ledger entries also. For 14 marks, separate set of books of accounts are maintained. From that, you will get 114 marks. From any one, you will get for 6 marks. It may be journal entries or it may be ledger entries. Almost all the times, they used to ask ledger entries only. Now, let us start with the first method when separate set of books are maintained for joint venture. Generally, co-ventures carry other business activities along with the joint venture business also. Sometimes they do make competition between their own business with joint venture activities. Since joint venture is a temporary contract, the co-ventures do not keep separate set of books of accounts for joint venture. That is the reason. However, if joint venture size is a big and carried for long term period, then they do maintain separate set of books for joint venture. The co-ventures maintain a separate set of books of accounts apart from their regular business books of accounts. When they are maintaining separate set of books of accounts, it helps to find out the correct profit or loss of joint venture and contribution made by each co-venture. It also specifies balance to be paid or received from the co-venture. So it will be helpful in order to find out the profit, in order to say how much the venture need to pay, how much the balance is there in venture capital account. So those things can be easily find out by preparing separate set of books of accounts. Now let us start with the journal entries. Following are the journal entries to be made when separate set of books are maintained. First journal entry is when the contribution made by the co-venture. So when at the starting of the joint venture, the co-ventures need to invest or they need to give money. So if they are providing money, so for that also we need to make an entry, that is joint bank account debtor to co-ventures account. So the money is we are receiving, so that is the reason it will be bank account. Usually they used to maintain a bank account, so for that the money will go creditors. The one who is going to give money is co-ventures, so we're going to enter in the name, that is co-ventures name. Second journal entry is when the expenses paid through joint bank account. So if any expenditures are done in joint venture, then they used to pay through bank account. So that is the reason we are preparing the entry for that also. That is joint venture account debtor to joint bank account. So the money is going out from the bank. That is the reason bank will be on the credit side. And it usually benefiting for joint venture account, that will be on the debit side. Then we have third journal entry. When the expenses paid or material supplied by the co-venture from private account. So when the expenses are materials which is supplied by the co-venture. So that will be recorded with one entry, that is joint venture account debtor to co-venture account. So the material used to received by the venture, so that is the reason on the debit side we will have joint venture account. So it will be provided by the co-ventures, that is the reason we are going to record with co-ventures name. Next general entry is when the sale proceeds or collections. When they are done sale or by selling it, if they are receiving income, we are going to make an entry. So the usually income will receive to bank. That is the reason on the debit side, we will have joint bank account that are to joint venture account. On the fifth entry, we have when the collections received by the co-ventures. For that, we are going to make an entry of co-ventures account that are to joint venture account. So any collections which will be received separately by the co-ventures, then we are going to record in their name. Next journal entry is when the assets taken over by the co-venture. Sometimes at the end of the joint venture, some assets and liabilities may taken over by the ventures, co-ventures. So for that also we need to make an entry in the name, that is who is going to take over the assets, that is co-ventures account in their co-venture name on the debit side. On the credit side, we are going to record with joint venture account. Next general entry is when the liability is taken over by the co-venture. For that also we are going to make an entry with joint venture account debtor to co-venture account. On the eighth one, when there is a profit on joint venture. So either they'll get profit or either they'll get loss at the end of the joint venture. That is joint venture account debt R to co-venture account if it is profit. And if it is loss, co-venture account debt R to joint venture account. On the last journal entry, when the final settlement made to co-ventures. At the end of the joint venture, they used to do settlement for the co-ventures. So for that also, we are going to make an entry, that is co-venture account debt R to joint bank account. So here, we usually mention the name of the co-ventures in all the co-ventures account. Whatever the name we had, two or more persons or three persons or two persons usually will be there. Those names will be recorded in the place of co-ventures account. So other than that, everything will be same. Usually journal entries, they're not asking for 14 marks. But even though you should know at least 10 journal entries, if they ask you to prepare journal entries, if the separate books are maintained. Next, we'll start with the ledger accounts. When separate set of books are maintained, there will be three accounts we are supposed to prepare. One is joint venture account. Let us understand what is joint venture account. Usually it is a nominal ledger account. It incorporates transactions made exclusively in joint venture in order to find out whether it is profit or loss. It is maintained from the starting day of the joint venture to the date of dissolution, that is at the end. Then the expenses and the purchases made for joint venture, when they are doing joint venture, the sum of the expenditures or purchase they need to make, for that the entries will be on the debit side. And the incomes and sales are made in joint venture will be credited on the joint venture account. So finally, after debiting and after crediting those items, they usually get profit or loss, and that will be shared among the co-ventures. If they are mentioning the profit ratio or loss, profit and loss ratio, they usually distribute on that. If they are not mentioning that profit or loss ratio, then we can take equally to the co-ventures. So let us start from the debit side. First one, we have co-venture account, that is stocks or assets introduced by co-venture. If any co-venture is doing some expenditure on asset purchasing or any stock purchasing or any goods are there purchasing in order to make complete the joint venture, then usually that will be entered on the debit side in the name of co-venture account. Second entry on the debit side, we usually record co-ventures account again. That is for expenses paid by the co-venture. If any expenditure happened to the joint venture, for that expenditure, if it is paid by the co-venture, then that will be recorded on the debit side in the name of the co-venture who has done expenditure. Then on the one more entry, that is joint bank account, expenses paid. If any expenditure happened to the business, that is for a joint venture, if that expenditure paid through bank, usually some expenditure will paid individually by the persons, that is co-ventures. Sometimes collectively they used to pay the money through bank account. For that we are going to record in the name of joint bank account. Apart from that, credit side, joint bank account, sales or income received. If they have done sales or if they are receiving money, then usually will be recorded in the name of joint bank account. That money will be received through joint bank account. Then co-ventures account, sale or income received by the co-venture. If they are receiving income separately with the persons, on their name, the account will be created on the credit side. And lastly, if we are getting balance on the debit side, so that will be distributed as a profit with the profit sharing ratio. If they have not given that ratio, we usually take it as equally. If we are getting balance on the credit side, it will be considered as loss. It will be also distributed on the ratio. If they are not giving ratio, we need to distribute as equally. And one more important thing, you need to remember this joint venture account importantly, because based on this account only, other two accounts will be recorded. So that is the reason I'm saying whatever the each entries are there in this joint venture account. So keep it remember, because this will be helpful in order to complete other two ledger accounts. The second ledger account we are supposed to prepare, co-ventures account. So under that, how many co-ventures will be there in joint venture, we are going to take that many columns for amount. As you can see, for example, I have taken as two co-ventures in the name of X and Y. So whatever the name will be there, that will be recorded in this co-venture account. So usually this co-venture account will depend on how we are going to do joint venture account. Okay, that is the reason I'm saying joint venture account will be most important one. If you have done that properly, then other two accounts will be also, we can easily do. So always start from credit side for this account, because joint bank account we are supposed to consider first when we have started with the co-venture. So first always consider joint bank account on the credit side. Whatever the money they have invested while starting the joint venture, that will be recorded here. Okay, after that, whatever the entries we use to record under joint venture, so that can be transferred here. So for example, on the debit side, you can see joint venture account, sale or income received. Whatever the income sale they have received as a individually, as a co-venture, that will be recorded here. Then on the debit side, joint venture account, if any loss, as I told you, if we are getting loss under joint venture account, that will be transferred here. And whatever the distribution we have made, for that distribution will be entered on each co-venture column. Then on the credit side, joint venture account, if any sale of goods are introduced, so that will be recorded. If any goods are introduced by the particular co-venture, so that will be recorded here. These entries will be there in the joint venture account, only we need to take as transfer to that account, to the co-venture's account. Next, we have joint venture account expenses paid. If any expenses paid by individual co-venture, that will be recorded here, and the amount will be recorded in their particular column. Then we have a joint venture account. If it is profit, what we have done in the first account, joint venture account, if we are getting profit as a balance, that profit will be recorded on the debits, credit side of the co-venture's account. In their co-venture's column, the amount will be entered. After that, if we are getting a balance on the debit side, we usually record in the name of joint bank account. It will be transferred to the joint bank account while preparing the next account. If we are getting the same balance on the credit side, it will be also mentioned in the same account, that is joint bank account, and it will be also transferred to joint bank account, what we are going to prepare in the next account. Remember, while preparing this co-venture account, most important thing is, by starting this account, you're going to see joint bank account, how much money they have introduced when they're starting joint venture. Apart from this, all the entries will be there in joint venture account. Only we need to transfer those entries. If it is on the debit side, you can take on the credit side. If it is on the credit side, you can take on the debit side. Only you need to transfer to between the accounts. So that is the reason I'm saying first account is very much important. In the second account, only one entry you need to carefully enter, that is joint bank account. Apart from that, whatever the entries you have made on the joint venture account, that will be transferred to co-venture account. The third ledger account we are going to prepare in the name of joint bank account. Here, when we are preparing this account, we need to transfer the entries only related to joint bank account from the first two accounts. What we used to have, joint bank account, from the two accounts what we have already prepared, from that we need to transfer to this account in simple. So first entry on the debit side, co-ventures account, cash introduced. Whatever the cash which is done or which is given to start the joint venture, so that will be recorded in the co-venture account, that will be transferred here. So either it will be entered in this. Then on the second entry, joint venture account, if any sale or income received directly to the bank, then that will be recorded in the name of joint venture account. So this will be also there in joint venture account, as we are, that is the first ledger account. Then on the credit side, by joint venture account, any expenses paid by the joint venture collectively, that will be there on the first ledger account, that will be transferred here. Then lastly, what we have prepared co-ventures account, on that we usually get the balance. If we are getting balance as surplus, that will be recorded in the credit side. If we are getting balance as deficient, that will be recorded on the debit side. So those will be recorded in this account, and we are going to do the total. Total will be equal on both the sides. So it should be equal. Then we can say the ledger what we have prepared, it is correct. Remember, preparing first ledger is very much important. If you have prepared first ledger properly, then other two ledgers will be very much easy. Only we need to transfer the accounts from one account to another account. That is the reason I'm saying first ledger will be very much important. In second ledger, you're going to only enter one by looking the illustration, and other information you can transfer from first ledger. While coming to third ledger, you can easily transfer all the entries what you have done on the two ledgers. Apart from these three ledger accounts, usually you will get one more ledger account, that is in the name of equity shares account. If the joint venture is dealing with cash as well as equity shares, then we need to prepare equity shares. In the next session, we are going to learn how to solve the illustrations under joint venture. I'll give some of the important keynotes and I'll give some tricks to solve this illustration easily. And this is also very much easiest chapter. You can easily take 14 marks from this by preparing only 3 accounts. And now we are in the end of the session. So I hope you guys have understood this explanation about introduction, about journal entries, difference, and also ledger accounts. If you are having any doubts, please mention in the comment section, and thank you for watching.